All right, guys, welcome back. Happy Friday. Tackling these concepts in training. Going to be looking at the frontal plane a little bit more, right? So when we look at frontal plane, we're dividing the body this way, right? So when we move, we're moving side to side. We're moving laterally. That's kind of how we move inside the frontal plane. Now, one of the things, and we're going to talk more about issues with the frontal plane, how people basically turn it into a sagittal plane movement, because when we look at the frontal plane, we're trying to get outside of our base of support. So if I look at sagittal movement, a lot of times what we're really looking at is our hips and our rib cage are inside of our base of support. So if I were to do a squat, well, I am literally stacked up in my base of support. If I'm doing a bench press, I'm stacked in my base of support. When we look at frontal plane movement, we need to get outside our base of support, right? And this is, we're going to use the lateral lunge as a great example. And there's an interview that Kyle Dobbs of Compound Performance did with Joel Smith of Just Fly Sports. So that's on the Just Fly Sports podcast if you want a really interesting listen. Being able to get outside the base of support is really what's going to help us change movements into a lateral or frontal plane movement. So a lot of times we're going to use the lateral lunge as an example. People do a lateral lunge and they'll step out and they'll sink and then they push back, right? Well, if you notice, I'm still inside my foot, my pelvis, my rib cage, all inside my foot, okay? If we really want to change this movement into a frontal plane movement, well, really what we need is we need to get outside our base of support, right? So right in this position, I'm trying to stick my pelvis outside my foot. My rib cage is stacked over my foot, okay? We're translating past our main base support, right? We're loading up completely on one leg. So you can do this either as a dynamic movement, right, and sinking, right? And now notice I even had to bring my foot in a little bit over here to create enough length, create enough motion to sink outside and get outside the base of support. We can do that also as a stationary movement, right? And being able to just sit there, shorten up that base support and sink down and try to get outside that base of support, okay? Same thing would kind of be true with our lateral movements, upper body wise, right? People are like, oh, well, I did a lateral raise. Well, that's not really, we're still kind of supported in that base support. Being able to move in a position where we get outside the base of support and being able to move dynamically into those positions, right? So same thing would also be true if I were to try to get outside my base of support, if I were to rotatingly lunge, still sinking out into that position and pushing back, right? So it's got a rotational lunge, being able to understand that if we're trying to move inside the frontal plane, we're trying to get outside the base of support, trying to get our ribs and our hips moving laterally. If I do this position, if I just do my standard lateral lunge, right? Well, if I'm here, I'm still inside. I don't have that much movement on my rib cage and pelvis. If I step and I sink, all of a sudden I've got more translation of my ribs and pelvis laterally, and then pushing back, right? So when we look at frontal plane, we're really looking at the amount of movement that we can create laterally with the hips and the pelvis and the rib cage, and it really trying to get outside of our base of support in order to really train in the frontal plane. So that's a brief overview of the frontal plane, kind of using the lateral lunge as an example. Obviously, there's a lot more different exercises we could get into that are really going to play a role, but for the base of this video, just being able to understand, right? Using that movement where we're trying to get in the frontal plane, we got to change our base of support, get outside of it, and trying to then optimize and move the rib cage and the pelvis and move them laterally and not just moving a foot laterally. So that's the frontal plane. We've talked about the sagittal plane. We'll talk about the transverse plane a little bit more in coming videos.